إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. وبعد، before I continue, can I ask the brothers to come as far forward as they are able, so that those brothers at the back have somewhere to pray before they sit down. Barakallahu feekum. It has been collected by Ibn Asakir in Tariq Dimashq from Yahya bin Jabir al-Miqdam bin Ma'di Karib al-Kindi that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as he mentioned, قام في الناس فحمد الله وأثنى عليه وقال, that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that he stood amongst the people, he praised Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and glorified him, and then he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إن الله يوصيكم بالنساء خيرا, and he said that three times, that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stated that indeed Allah advises you to take good care of women, and he said, repeating it again, that indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yusikum bin nisa khairan, that he advises you to take good care of women, or that he advises you with the strongest terms to be good to your women. And then he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, fa innahunna ummuhatakum, that indeed they are your mothers, وَبَنَاتُكُمْ, and that they are your daughters, وَأَخَوَاتُكُمْ, and that they are your sisters, وَأَمَّاتُكُمْ, and that they are your paternal aunts, وَخَالَاتُكُمْ, and that they are your maternal aunts, meaning the sisters of your mothers. And then the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam continued by saying that indeed a man from the people who were given the two books, or the people of the two books, meaning the Jews and the Christians, that one of them would marry a woman and he would not beat her, he would not hit her, and each of them would continue to desire his companion or her companion up until they died in old age. This hadith been authenticated by the great scholar Sheikh Muhammad bin Muhammad Nasiruddin Al-Albani rahimahullah ta'ala. This hadith, my brothers and sisters, shows the great importance of showing good care and companionship to one's wife. So much so that one of the scholars, Abu Salama, that he said that I narrated this hadith to Al-Ala bin Sufyan Al-Ghassani, who said, as Sheikh Al-Albani has collected in his As-Sahiha volume 6, that indeed has reached me that from their evil hidden sins, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made haram, which are not clearly mentioned in the Quran, are that a man marries a woman and when his companion she becomes old and she has stayed with him for a long period of time and she has produced all her womb can produce, then he divorces her without any reason to do so. Sheikh Al-Albani mentions the authenticity of that narration and the hadith that came before. Then Sheikh Nasir rahimahullah ta'ala mentions a narration from Al-Harbi rahimahullah ta'ala, who said, that the intent in this is to encourage the one being advised to have concern for the women, to have patience with them, and that the people of the book used to behave like that with their women. Shaykh al-Albani rahimahullah ta'ala, after mentioning all of this, he comments that this is how the Jews and the Christians used to behave when they used to have good manners and they were religious, even though they followed a religion that had changed. And as for nowadays, then those very same Jews and Christians, that they prohibit that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made permissible of divorce, and then they openly make zina something permissible. But the wisdom behind this hadith that we have quoted at the beginning, that the women that we marry, and the women folk in general, what are they? Except that they are mothers, except that they are sisters, except that they are daughters, except that they are aunts, either from the father's side or from the mother's side. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned the narration in which he stated, verily you have a right upon your women, and your women have rights upon you. Your right upon them is that they should not admit anyone to sit upon your furnishings or to enter your home, the one whomsoever that you dislike. And verily their right upon you is that you treat them well in terms of clothing and in terms of giving them provision of food. The hadith collected by Imam Tirmidhi, Ibn Majah and Nasa'i, authenticated by the great scholar Shaykh Al-Albani rahimahullah ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned the bonds between the believing men and the believing women. وَالْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتِ بَعْدُهُمْ أَوْلِيَاءُ بَعْدٍ, that the believing men and the believing women, that they are friends, allies and protectors one of another. They are the awliya of each other. يَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَيَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ, that they enjoin that which is good and they forbid that which is evil. وَيُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةَ وَيُؤْتُونَ الزَّكَاةَ وَيُطِيعُونَ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ وَأُولَئِكَ سَيَرْحَمُهُمُ اللَّهُ إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَزِيزٌ حَكِيمٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues to say that they enjoin the prayer, or they establish the prayer, and they give the zakah, and they obey Allah and they obey His Rasul. They are the ones whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will show His mercy or shower His mercy upon. And indeed Allah is almighty and all wise. The advice here being that the believers, men and women, are friends and protectors and allies of one another. Men and women. That includes the relationship between the husband and his wife. That includes the relationship between a father and his daughter, a man and his aunt, a brother and his sister. That they are awliya one to another. And it is not permissible to mistreat them. And this is why the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, with regard to being good to the women folk, being good to one's wife. And the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam strongly advised us. And that's why he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stated that indeed they are your mothers, they are your daughters, they are your sisters, they are your aunties, as the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned. And then he brought an example from the people of the book. And then he mentioned that one of them would marry a woman. And in a narration he said that one of them would marry a woman and she would not know even how to pull a string or untie a knot. Yet they would not depart from each other up until death. They would not depart from each other up until death. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned with regard to the women, وَعَاشِرُوهُنَّ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ, so live with them in goodness. فَإِنْ كَرِحْتُمُوهُنَّ, and if you were to dislike something in them, فَعَسَىٰ أَنْ تَكْرَهُ شَيْئًا فَيَجْعَلَ اللَّهُ فِيهِ خَيْرًا كَثِيرًا, for indeed if you dislike them, or if you dislike something within them, perhaps you dislike a thing, and Allah makes therein much good. So it is possible for an individual to dislike something, but in that thing that he dislikes, maybe there is much good in it. Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah ta'ala, he has brought a chapter heading. The chapter heading, advice with regard to the women. Then he mentioned a hadith narrated or brought from Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that whomsoever believes in Allah in the last day then he should not harm his neighbor. And this is from the huquq and from those rights that are between mankind, that one does not harm his neighbor. As the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, or Aisha radiallahu anha mentioned, with regard to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam never used to take revenge due to something that was done to him personally. But if the Book of Allah, or if Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam were disobeyed, or Allah was disobeyed by way of the revelation, then he would become angry for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So these are the rights that even if sometimes you are harmed by those who are next to you or close to you, from your neighbors, from your family members, then one should not seek vengeance and one should not be a vengeful, revengeful type of person. So the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that whomsoever believes in Allah on the last day, then let him not harm his neighbor. Advise you strongly, he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I advise you strongly to be good to the women folk. Indeed, women were created from the rib bone, and the most bent of the ribs is the rib, is the top one, is the upper one. So if one of you tried to straighten it, then you would break it. And if you left it alone, it would remain crooked. So I advise you to be good to your women. So the women, they are the daughters. She is a mother. She is a daughter. She is a sister. And with regard to all of this, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has advised us and given us advice with regard to all of these types of relationship with the women. As Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that he advised in a narration with regard to the women, and especially with regard to that relationship, which is the uppermost relationship with regard to a man and another woman, and that is the relationship with his own mother. So he explained, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that she is the mother. And the mother, ya ikhwan, and I'm sure that many of you heard these narrations before with regard to one's mother, that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in that narration from Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, who said, جاء رجل إلى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فقال يا رسول الله, that a man came to the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم and he said, oh Messenger of Allah, من أحق الناس بحسن صحابتي وصحبتي, that the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, that he was asked by this individual, who was the greatest, who is the most deserving of the right of my good companionship? So the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, أمك, he said, your mother. He said, ثم من, he said, whom they after? He said, your mother. He said, ثم who after her? He said, your mother. And then he said, who after her? And then he said, ثم أبوك, he said, then your father. So the mother deserved the right of companionship three times the right of the father. And this is something that is established in a narration. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, أباك, he said, then your father, ثم الأقرب فالأقرب, then your father, and then whomsoever is close and closer. So whomsoever is closer, then whomsoever is closer, meaning the closest of relatives. And this is something, ya ikhwan wa akhawat, something that is established in the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with regard to the family relations, with regard to the rights of the wife, with regard to the rights of the mother, with regard to the rights of the father, with regard to the rights of those relatives that are close to us. That a society that is established, that is built upon the establishment of these rights of blood and relationship for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that these are rights that will firm, or that will establish a society upon a good and strong footing. A man came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on an occasion and he said, ya Rasulullah, I wish to make jihad alongside you. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, is your mother alive? He said, yes, O Messenger of Allah, she is alive. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, then cling to her feet, for indeed you will find paradise there. For indeed paradise is there. So clinging to the feet of the mother in search of paradise, that an individual should understand that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has given rights to the parents greater or more virtuous on occasions than even jihad in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In this narration that we have just spoken of, where the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned fal aqrab, that those who are closer, wal aqrab, and those who are closer. In this narration, that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is indicating here the relationships that are close, meaning the mother, then the father, then those who are close, And from those who are close, my brothers and sisters, without doubt, from them is the wife, the daughter, the sister, the aunt. And no one can doubt, O servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how close those relationships are. As for the saying, the most deserving of my good companionship, as the man asked the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, meaning, who are the most foremost, or who are the foremost people with whom I should fulfill my favors, to be good to them and to honor them with good speech, with kindness, with gentleness, with good dealings, implementing good manners. Who is the one who is most deserving of this? And the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned that which he mentioned. Al-Hafidh ibn Hajar in Fath al-Bari, he mentions a statement from Ibn Battal in which he said that this warrants that the mother should be given three times as much as the father. And that is because of the difficulty of pregnancy, firstly. Secondly, that of delivery, the difficulty of delivering that child. And thirdly, because of the suckling. These things are specific to the mother, and hardships upon her that the father does not face. And then after that, the father, he participates in the upbringing of the child after these three immense barriers and difficulties that the mother has to go through. And this was also indicated in the statement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَوَسَّيْنَا الْإِنسَانَ بِوَالِدَيْهِ حَمَلَتْهُ أُمُّهُ وَحْنًا عَلَى وَحْنٍ وَفِصَالُهُ فِي عَامَيْنِ أَنِشْكُرْ لِي وَوَالِدَيْكَ إِلَيَّ الْمَصِيرُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, and we have enjoined upon man to be good to his parents, for indeed his mother bore him in weakness and in hardship, weakness upon weakness, and his weaning is in 2 years. So then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, anishkur li, so give thanks to me and to your parents, unto me is the final destination. Likewise the woman, as in the hadith of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that they are your mothers, they are your daughters, they are your wives, and so on, that she is the wife. And the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has exhorted us with regard to our wives and with regard to our families. خَيْرُكُمْ خَيْرُكُمْ لِأَهْلِهِ, as the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, that the best of you are those who are best to their wives. وَأَنَا خَيْرُكُمْ لِأَهْلِهِ, and I am the best of you to my wives or to my family. But in this context, meaning one's wives. And then the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَإِذَا مَاتَ صَاحِبُكُمْ, so if your companion was to die, فَدَعُوهُ, then make dua for him. So the best of you is the one who is best to his wife. And I'm the best of you to my wife. And if your companion should die, then make dua for him. Shaykh al-Albani rahimahullah ta'ala has mentioned that this is something that has been collected by the likes of Ibn Hibban and Daruqutni and others. And then he mentions that here the wording wives, due to the hadith in which the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stated that the most complete of the believers in their iman are those who have the best manners, and the best of you are those who are best to their women. So no doubt the wives are included in that khitab or in the address of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So she is the daughter, no doubt, as the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has mentioned with regard to how one should deal with one's daughters. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stated in a narration, whomsoever has three daughters and is patient with them, fed them and gave them drink and clothed them from his wealth, then there will be a screen for him from the hellfire on the day of resurrection. So this is the exhortation of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with regard to looking after one's daughters. They are women, they are weak, and sometimes they are open and prone to abuse. So Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is exhorting and commanding us to be good to our women folk, because they are the weaker out of the two sexes. They are the ones who can be corrupted and abused, and they are the ones who can be discarded, as Shaykh al-Albani rahimahullah ta'ala mentioned with regard to how the people of the book used to be, that they used to be good to their women. But now you find the opposite of that which is taking place, that they used to marry their women even if she was a woman who could not do anything, couldn't even pull a string, yet they would stay together up until one of them died. Up until death did they part. So the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is using that particular example Sheikh Al-Albani, رحمه الله تعالى, commenting that this is in opposition to what is taking place amongst them in our times. That yes, you'll find them in our times, that they will raise their daughters whilst they're young, spoiling them, giving them everything. But when they reach the age of puberty and adolescence, that they will leave their daughters to the streets, committing all types of obscenity. Obscenities, my brothers and sisters, are unheard of in the history of mankind, never mind in the history of modern civilization. والحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على شرف المرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وبعد. Imam al-Bukhari brings a chapter heading in his Al-Adab al-Mufrad. Chapter heading, whomsoever is responsible for supplying sustenance for two daughters or even one daughter. Then we have that narration mentioned in the Musnad of Imam Ahmad. That he said, Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam, no one has three daughters or three sisters or two daughters or two sisters, and he fears Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala regarding them and is good to them, except that he will enter into paradise. From the reasons and the causes of entering into Jannah is showing goodness to your sisters, showing goodness to your daughters, feeding them, providing for them, and looking after them. Abdullah ibn Abbas, from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, who said that no Muslim who has two daughters and he has good companionship with them, except that they will be a cause for him entering into paradise. So no doubt, my brothers and sisters, she is a sister. She is a paternal aunt, a maternal aunt, and they have all been mentioned with the advice of being good to them. As for the paternal aunt and the maternal aunt, meaning the sister of the father and the sister of the mother, then no doubt Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Sharia of Al-Islam has encouraged the Muslims to have good relations with them and to be good to them, and that they are from the closest of relatives. No one can doubt that the paternal aunt and the maternal aunt are connected to a Muslim from the direction of his mother and the father. Therefore the paternal aunt, meaning the sister of the father and the sister of the mother, are in the same status as the mother and the father, as many of the ulama and the sahaba radiallahu anhum have mentioned. Due to this, it becomes obligatory to have good relations with them. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned the hadith reported by Imam al-Bukhari, Imam Ahmad in his Musnad, and Abu Dawud in his Sunan, that the maternal aunt is at the status of the mother. The maternal aunt, meaning the sister of your mother, is on the level of your mother. Imam al-Tirmidhi mentions in his Sunan, the chapter heading, being good to the maternal aunt, and with a chain of narration reaching back to Al-Bara ibn Azib, from the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stated that the aunt is at the status of the mother. And this hadith Imam al-Tirmidhi mentions as a long story behind it, from Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu anhuma, who said that Amman came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he said, indeed I've committed a major sin. Is there any repentance for me? So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, do you have a mother? He said, no. He said, do you have an aunt, a khala? Do you have an aunt, meaning a sister of your mother? He said, yes. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, then be good to her. In the Sunan of Imam al-Darimi, Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu anhuma, who said, a maternal aunt is the same status of the mother, and the paternal aunt is of the same status as the father. The niece is at the same status of the uncle, and every relative is of the same status of his relation who is equivalent thereof, even if that person is not an inheritor. And we also have in the Sunan of Daruqutni from Sha'bi, who said, Ziyad bin Abi Sufyan said to a person who would sit with him, he said, do you know how Umar judged regarding the paternal aunt and the maternal aunt? He said, no. Then Ziyad, he said to him, indeed I am the most knowledgeable of the creation about how Umar radiallahu anhu judged. He placed the maternal aunt at the same status of the mother, and the maternal aunt, and the paternal aunt is the same status as the father. The Prophet ﷺ encouraged this ummah, therefore, my brothers and sisters. And he encouraged them by giving good advice to them, to be good and to treat the women folk with goodness. Just as you would like your daughter, your own daughter, your own sister, your own paternal aunt, your own maternal aunt to be judged, then likewise, you would wish that for someone else's paternal aunt, someone else's daughter, someone else's sister. Would that not make you happy if your daughter was happy? Would it not make you happy if your sister was happy? Then how about if you have in your grasp and you have as a captive with you someone else's sister, someone else's daughter, someone else's female relative, someone else's aunt, that you have this person who is with you and you do not give them good treatment? The Prophet ﷺ mentioned all of these hadith that we have mentioned so as to exhort us to be good to our women folk. That indeed this ummah of Muhammad ﷺ, that they are better than the ummah that came before. They are better than the Jews and the Christians. And the Messenger of Allah ﷺ gave the example of the Jews and the Christians, that they would not beat their women, and they would be patient with them, and they would remain with them till death. And as the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, and if one of you dies, then make dua for him. If one of you dies, or if your companion dies, your wife dies, then show them goodness by making dua for them. Abu Huraira mentioned that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned that every person from the children of Adam is a master. So the man is the master of his family, and the woman is the mistress of her home. And likewise, we have that narration collected by Imam al-Bukhari in Adab al-Mufrad, and likewise Ibn Majah, authenticated by the great scholar and the Mujaddid and the Muhaddith, Sheikh Muhammad Nasiruddin al-Albani rahimahullah, that there was a man who came, who was with the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the man's son came and he kissed his father. So a man was sitting with the Messenger of Allah, and his son came and he kissed his father, and he sat upon the lap of his father. So then the daughter of that man, the young girl, she turned up, and she came and she just, literally she came and sat next to her father. So then the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam turned to him and he said to him, if only you had been just between the two of them. Look at the justice of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That due to the fact that the boy came and kissed his father, sat in his lap. And the daughter, she came and she did not kiss him and she did not sit in his lap, but rather she sat next to him. That the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw something in there of disparity. That the boy kisses and sits in the lap. Likewise, my brothers and sisters, we should do the same with our daughters. That we should be with our daughters with piety and goodness. That we should be with our daughters just as we are with our sons, in showing them love and affection and closeness, because societies are built upon these types of affairs. As you find the statement of many of the people that they say that from knowing how good a society is, how cohesive a society is, and how much justice a society has, from those affairs that show how much justice a society has, is the manner in which they treat their weakest. So the girls are weak, and our daughters are weak. Our sisters are weak out of the two sexes. Easy to abuse them. How does the Muslim treat them? How does the father treat his daughter? How does the brother treat his sister? How does the husband treat his wife? All of these are signs and characteristics of good manners and good etiquette in the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If these types of affairs are corrupted and they are not given attention, then society itself begins to disintegrate. Society itself begins to fall apart, because these things that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave importance to, when we don't give importance to them, then we find that society begins to collapse and fall apart. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the ability to learn the manners from the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and take these pieces of advice from the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wa salam and the early salaf, in the manner in which they used to treat their women folk and treat their daughters and their sisters and their mothers and their aunts and the women folk in general. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from those who take recognition and we benefit from these words. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.